Warriors tried to use a player who was ineligible. The said player had been suspended during the week, and we sent the Warriors chairman an email with the letter confirming that he was suspended on Thursday before the match. After that, the Warriors chairman came to my office and had a chat with myself and the president, and we explained to him that the player is ineligible, but he insisted on using the said player on Saturday. So we had no choice but to award the walkover against Warriors.
With just a few days left before the Uganda Cup semi-final matches are played, a storm is brewing in Uganda club rugby ranks. The storm is by and large the product of the Uganda Rugby Union's decision to ban Warriors open side flanker Zeno Owora Othieno. Warriors insist that banning Othieno was done arbitrarily.
The letter did not even have a date indicating when the ban would take effect. Yep. The letter was addressed to Mutoni Warriors. Technically, our relationship with Mutoni ended about 18 months ago. So I believe even that was communicated to the union. So there are a lot of technicalities involved. The beauty is the union allows us to appeal this, but our biggest concern was the fact that the union did not involve us when they say the said player was summoned and failed to make the summons and be in the whole disciplinary process.
The grapevine has been buzzing with talk of Warriors pursuing a legal process that will put this weekend's Uganda Cup matches on the back burner.
What we are asking from the union is to have due respect for all procedure. We cannot have you quote procedure when it only favors you. Yeah, in the case of you delivering the letter a couple of minutes of the game, I believe technically that is wrong. Zeno is a core player. Zeno is core part of our game plan. Yeah. And everyone that knows how we work knows we have mutual respect for everyone. There's no one bigger than the sport, as Ramsey said. And we'd also say there's no one that owns the sport. Yeah. So we cannot have a few individuals usurping someone's power, thinking that it's their sole right. And if any of this communication that they claimed was coming through, they should have done it with due diligence.
It remains to be seen how the episode will end. One thing, though, is for sure. Uganda Rugby Union has suffered quite some reputational damage.